This speaking book will explain what biobanks are, why they are important, and how you can help future generations. Sometimes people get very sick and doctors do not know why or how to make the person better. Special people called researchers help doctors and nurses to find out what the sickness is and what caused it. Researchers ask people in communities to help them with their research. Research is a way for people to find answers to questions. In medical research, we want to find out more about diseases to find a better way of treating people who are sick. Researchers do this by studying human samples like blood. These samples are stored in a biobank. A biobank is like a library. The same way books are kept safe and organized in a library, biological samples are kept safe and organized in a biobank. But instead of bookshelves, biological samples are put in freezers. Different biobanks store human, animal, plant, virus, or bacterial samples. A human biobank can store biological samples like blood, sputum, urine, skin cells, organ tissue, or DNA. The samples are used to study diseases like cancer, diabetes, HIV and AIDS, or TB. All these samples contain something called DNA, which is what makes the body work. By studying DNA, researchers can find new treatments and ways to cure diseases. The alphabet has 26 letters that we use to make words and then write sentences. In the same way, DNA has an alphabet of its own that consists of four letters, A, G, C, and T. Human DNA contains 3 billion of these letters that are organized into sentences that tell a story. DNA tells the cells what to do. Just like we use rules to start a sentence with a capital letter and we end a sentence with a full stop, the DNA language also has rules that say how the sentences are read and when to stop reading. When the words in the DNA sentences are spelled wrong, we say that the DNA has errors. Researchers call these errors mutations and do studies to see what caused them. For example, if one of the letters, T, in a sentence of DNA has changed to another letter, G, then researchers say that the DNA has errors in it. The DNA spelling errors, or mutations, occur as we grow older. Some of these errors are passed down from parent to child. Sometimes these errors can cause diseases like diabetes or cancer. Work done today might save the life of a child that will be born in the future. You may be wondering how researchers transport and store a sample. If you choose to donate a biological sample for researchers to study, the sample is transported at room temperature to a biobank. It will be kept in a secure room that is full of freezers. Your samples are kept safely in the biobank and can be used now or in the future. A freezer can contain a lot of different samples. All of the information that you give to the researchers is put into a computer and only a few people can see what is on the computer. Researchers keep track and control of the samples stored in the freezers by using special computer programs like the BioBab Laboratory Information Management System. Each of the samples get a special number called a code. Because you are given a special number that only you and the researchers know, the researchers protect your identity. Your personal information, including your name, is always kept secret or confidential and stored safely on a computer. All the information is very strictly controlled and very few people can access it. You can choose whether or not to donate any biological samples for a research study, and participation in a study is voluntary. If you agree to assist and before you give a sample, you will be asked to sign a consent form. You are allowed to stop doing the test at any time. Nobody can force you to carry on if you do not want to. The researcher will explain all of this to you and will help you to completely understand what participating in a study means. We call this informed consent. Researchers must behave ethically, meaning that they must look after the best interests of the people taking part in research. Only researchers doing research which has been approved by experts, called a research ethics committee, can use any samples. If you change your mind, you can let the researcher know. The researcher will inform the biobank and they will remove your sample from the biobank and destroy it. You can ask for proof that they destroyed your sample. Biobanks will never sell your sample. Donating a sample will not cost you money. The researchers will pay to have your test done and will also pay for the collection, delivery, and storage of your samples in the biobank. Research that is finding better treatments for diseases can take many years, and new treatments may not be found in your lifetime. But by donating your sample, you will help future generations. It could even be your great-grandchild. This is why your sample, stored with your permission in a biobank, can be very important in building a healthy nation for generations to come.